Hi, I'm Mike Stanton. It's July 10th, 2020. This is the BAM Weekly Muni Market Update. I'm here with Dan Bingham and Chris Flossie from BAM's Capital Markets Desk. Thank you for joining me, gentlemen. Dan, let's start with you. It's been about 2 weeks since we last had an update. How have the markets behaved? Is stability continuing to reign in muni yields?
Sure. And I hope everyone had a great July 4th holiday weekend. But, you know, continuation of the trend with the Fed backstop in the treasury markets and the rate market continue to provide a strong bid side, and parts of the treasury curve hit record low yields this week. We saw the initial claims for unemployment come in pretty much in line with expectations of 1.3 million. So any kind of fear of a slowdown in the reopening process hasn't been reflected necessarily in the economic numbers there.
And so how does that translate into the muni market? We saw yields, you know, remarkably stable through the end of June. How do they open July?
Yeah, same trend there. The front end has been stable and has seen record length of no change in the MMD scale. On the short end, we've seen a continuation of a trend, somewhat seasonal, with the July 1st monies driving some support to the longer end. Overall, 30-year munis at 157 has ticked down about 5 basis points over the past week.
And then we saw a little over $1 billion of inflows again reported by Lipper this week. So they're still, you know, buying support from the retail investor.
Yep. So just over $1 billion, continuing that trend as well, with numbers that continue to support any kind of calendar that we might ultimately see.
We had some interesting headlines out of D.C., some new interest in stimulus packages, as well as potentially infrastructure investment packages. How did the market assess those? What are they watching for?
Sure. And it seems like with the developments that there's broad bipartisan support for another stimulus package, which will obviously have some market implications. But not only that, there has been an introduction or reintroduction of BAB and or advanced refunding legislation that could provide either additional issuance in the municipal market or the possibility of taking out some portion of the issuance or the traditional issuance and moving it to the taxable side. So certainly things that participants are watching pretty closely.
So, Chris, let's transition over to you and talk about the new issue market. After a quiet pre-holiday week last week, I think underwriters are back in business this week. What kind of activity did you see there?
That's right, Mike. So coming off the 4th of July holiday, BAM had a good week with we priced $200 million of insured paper. One deal to note is that Stifel brought a $61 million Roseville Joint Unified High School District COP deal in California. This deal was unique, and it had some low and discount coupons, and also was structured with an anytime call, which is something that we don't see all that often. Some other transactions to note are another Stifel transaction, but this time in Illinois, Williamsville School District number 15. That was a $40 million transaction, and then Benning and Scattergood priced a $25 million Lackawanna County, Pennsylvania transaction.
And that Roseville transaction is a good example of how investors have expanded their appetite for insured paper more recently, right? That's kind of a transaction with the anytime call may not have been insured prior to the COVID pandemic, but now investors are more conscious of having the protections. Is that fair?
Correct. I mean, that deal, even with that unique structure, it had a very good reception, was digested into the market without any real hiccups. So it was favorable for the issuer, and the underwriter had a favorable experience.
Great. So looking ahead to next week, another heavier calendar shaping up, although some of those deals we're still waiting to see how they're going to be priced and where demand is going to lie. What are you looking at on the calendar?
So next week's calendar, we're also expecting a solid week for BAM. Some deals on the calendar that are expected to price with BAM insurance are the Hillsdale Local School District deal in Ohio. That's a $75 million deal with Stifel. And Stifel's also bringing a $48 million Firestone Colorado Water Revenue Bond. We don't see that kind of size in Colorado all that often either. So, and also some other deals aside from the BAM awarded transactions are the Dallas-Fort Worth Airport deal. That's a $400 million deal with Siebert. Siebert's also expected to price a State University of New York transaction, and then Citi with a Rowan University transaction in New Jersey.
So all three of those transactions in sectors that have some exposure to the COVID economic disruption. So it'll be interesting to see how investors assess the financial positions of those issuers.
That's right. We're watching with some interest in those transactions.
Very good. Well, thanks, gentlemen, for joining us this week, and we'll see you soon.
Great. Thanks, Mike.
the market is unpredictable, BAM gives you certainty. In the face of volatility and illiquidity, BAM-insured municipal bonds deliver default protection, value preservation, and a durable AA rating from S&P. BAM's insurance protects against everything that causes a default, including natural disasters, financial fraud, pension issues, and economic disruption, like the one we're experiencing right now. BAM. Build America Mutual. Ask your broker about BAM-insured municipal bonds.